And welcome to 90 Notes. Well, in this lesson, we're just going to be drawing three of our platonic solids. And we like the cube so much, we're going to draw it twice. We're going to draw it as an oblique and a perspective cube. Now, I'll go a little faster because, you know, we've done this stuff before. Now, again, we're not constructing, but oblique means we're looking straight on. So, I mean, this is just a drawing of the square. I don't really care if you got the tick marks, but drawing means that you line up your straight edge and you just slide it. And, you know, and it's good enough. And then you turn your straight edge and you make that. I mean, you're just drawing that square. Nothing fancy there. But the only thing that makes it oblique, remember, then we're going to take our straight edge and we're going to give it an angle. And I'm saying somewhere between 30 and 45 degrees. And I want the distance that we draw to give the depth to be 1/2 or 2/3 the length. That is the length of this. So let me show you what I mean. Move this out of the way, and it's going to look a lot like that. See, this segment is actually shorter than that one, but it's representing the same length because it's giving it some depth. So go ahead and fill in the other sides, and you've got yourselves your cube. Now, you could, find the other ones here. I mean, you could straighten out your straight edge and draw in the others and draw in your hidden sides if you'd like. Or, you know, maybe you're just going to shade it, something like that. And, I mean, a tick mark's overwhelming. So let's, I'd say we back off of those and maybe just draw it just like that. And that looks like, it looks like a three-dimensional solid. And that's depicting a cube. Now, something else we did before, remember this? This is the two-point perspective. We gave ourselves a horizon line. And then let's start with an edge right there. So if you draw a vertical, so just take your straight edge and line it up vertically. And again, this is a drawing, not a construction. And then what are you going to do? Well, draw. Remember, we picked two vanishing points. Make it interesting. Have them at different distances apart. What do you do then? And of course, you're going to pick a pair of vertical lines. Vertical lines, take your straight edge parallel to this one, just slide it over, make this one. Now, that's going to give you a couple more from here to here. You're going to have to connect now. And you're going to connect your vanishing points up there. So you connect this one and connect these two points. And the cube just jumps out at you. And you can see the edges right there. And of course, that will mean you've got those six, or those three of the six visible faces. And, you know, we could do the hidden lines on this as well. I think this looks better this way as a perspective. So again, this is your drawing. And that's your, you've got your cube there, you've got your six faces, you've got your eight vertices, and you got your, what do you got there, you got 12 edges, and that works out beautifully. Okay, next one. Oh my goodness, heavens, Tom Murgatroyd's Timmy Tetrahedron. So honestly, on this one, you're just going to take your straight edge, and this is, I would just draw myself. I'm imagining a triangle. Maybe I'm drawing this one. And the tick marks are what tells you it's a triangle. And then I'm trying to imagine I've got one in a different plane going this way. And really, that's about all there is to it. If you want, you can go ahead and draw across the back. And I'd probably make that one dashed to show that that is a hidden line. Oops, sorry about the software there. And that's your, and that would be your hidden line. So draw, give yourself a pat on the back for that tetrahedron. And now let's go for the big one, the octahedron. Yikes. My hints for drawing this, let's first start by, I'm just going to draw a segment. We're going to draw a horizontal segment like this. And we're going to slide our straight edge. And we're going to make the parallel segment. And then we're going to connect the dots. And just like we did before. And you know what we're drawing. This is just a parallelogram. So I draw that in. And again, I'm using this parallelogram to represent an oblique square. This segment is actually about 2/3 of this one. So it gives it some depth, like you've got that square that's laying down. And let's get this out of the way, and let's figure out the smart way to go from here. We're going to, you know, and again, you could shade that, but why bother? These two are going to be visible edges, and these two will be in the background. So I'm writing them as hidden lines, making them nice and thin. Now, I've got to find a point in the middle. So again, I don't need to, I need to find a point in the middle here, and I could do that several ways. If I'm a constructing kind of guy, if I drew these, too harsh. If I drew those, the intersection of those two diagonals, that's the point that I want. You need to find that spot, but honestly, I don't want to see that. I just want you to find that magic point right there and draw a vertical line through it, or I should say perpendicular line. And, sorry about that. You're just going to draw a line through that point, and then you're going to pick a point on that line, I'd say up here, okay? And I'm going to pick a point below, down there. So again, I've got the middle of my polygon is right there, and I'm picking a point above and below because I'm going to do this. I'm going to connect the dots. And what I'm drawing, it looks like a square pyramid. Why? Because it is. And you can imagine that. See, that's that square pyramid I'm drawing. And then I'm going to draw the bottom the same way. And there you go. You've got yourselves an octahedron. So congratulations, Lynx. And get this one, drawn up. And you can turn that in with your homework. And thank you for watching 90 Notes.